Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 87 of the Realm Recap. I'm Jason from YakFace.com, joined as always by FlyGuy from FlyGuy.net.
Who's feeling 87? Yes, it's getting cold here. What about you? You getting cold?
Yeah, it's freezing cold. It's below zero. Well below zero.
It is below zero here too, I can repeat. Yeah, Hoth is coming, I think, for some of us. So
I'm getting sick warm, people. Really quick. I kind of want to go west or south or something. I'm done. But
something
anyway.
Tropical.
Yeah. A decent sized show again this week. A few new things popped up. New images of some basic figures. Figures that kind of popped up before Christmas have started showing up online and in stores, mostly like that new Rey figure. A couple of those. We had a few store reports this week. Lego
lots
stuff.
Lots
to talk about. Lots of Funko news and pop to talk about, as always. So we'll get things started with the Hasbro Kenner news for the week. Let's see. Walmart, again, seems to be the go-to place for anything new as of late. A lot of people have been finding the, like I mentioned, the Rey figure from The Force Awakens that has the new outfit and the lightsaber. This is also packed with Han Solo from The Force Awakens and the Hask Thug.
I love how this controversy for this figure has just completely now just fizzled out to a fart. Nobody really cares about it now. It's like, it's done. Yeah.
Much to do about nothing.
It really was, wasn't it? Just for the hell of it, legal lawsuits. But So, I think as we've said many times before, I mean, just because it's hit in one store, it may take ages. I think people sometimes just go bananas hunting for this thing. It's beginning anyway, beginning to arrive. So it's a good looking figure.
Yeah,
really good looking figure.
Sorry, I've seen various reports about this wave showing up from California to the Texas East Coast, Northwest, Northeast. It's been popping up around. So hopefully people will be able to find those in pretty short order and not have to worry too much about missing out on any figures. It should be easy enough. So, but again. Your mileage may vary depending on your store and how heavily it gets shopped.
Well, Rey, as you know as well, is just became the figure to have in every scale, articulated, non-articulated, her lightsaber, her 6-inch figure. So, yeah, it make sure you order or get this thing because it's going to sell quickly.
Yep. Couple new images of figures were released or leaked out this week. I'm sure these are going to be some of the ones that get shown off at Toy Fair officially, but figures like Admiral Ackbar, the Inquisitor, Fifth Brother Inquisitor. We've seen this one before, as early as I think San Diego Comic Con last year. But then the Tasu Leech figure.
Is he Kanji Club?
He's Kanji Club.
Kanji Club.
Delta.
He is Kanji Club. I thought that, yeah. All too briefly seen. I need to see this movie again and again to kind of remember who's who.
They're getting better and better looking. I mean, again, these are kind of Hasbro glamour official shots. You might have the mustache painted on the cheek or something, depending on your luck. Coffee. But what's kind of interesting about this figure in particular is it looks like Hasbro is looking to introduce some soft good type element to.
I thought that, yeah. It's kind of, it took me back to like an old vintage figure, the Klaatu, I think it was.
Yeah, yeah. So more of a plastic or vinylish looking cape. I'm not sure how rigid that plastic is, but it's definitely not the standard, T crotch type of leg articulation that we've received for a while now. So
I wonder if in 25 years, Jason, people will look back and go, if we just had a vinyl cape to Sao Leech or something,
Yeah.
I don't think it'll be quite the Jawa cape situation, but that would be funny. Anyway, these are good looking figures. They're definitely good. Even Ackbar's looking great. The paint looks, I mean, it is a glam shot, but wow.
Yeah, I'd take that one. I mean, that's a great looking deco. I hope it shows up looking like that. I mean, that's a pretty damn nice looking 5 POA figure. I don't, you know, if people who don't like this line can't recognize that, I'm not sure what hope there is, but yeah, that's nice.
I agree. That looks like a little Scottish flag on his chest there.
Yeah, no, it almost, that symbol kind of looks like, I mean, from that size, it almost looks like Anakin's pod racer flag.
That's true. Yes, that's true. Lovely weathering on the on old fish face there. Again, yeah. Glam shot could be, as you said, mileage may vary, but that almost looks like a jetpack or some build a thing there. But
some sort of apparatus.
You just don't know what it is, do you? Okay, never mind. But yeah, cool new figures coming.
Yep. So thanks to Jedi Defender for pointing those out. Those had shown up, I think, on an overseas online retailer, Forbidden Planet. So what else do we have? I think I hid my show notes here. What's the next one? Oh, Rey's lightsaber, I think.
Yes. Let's have a look for that.
Let's see. Here we go.
I've lost mine as well. Bear with me. I'll get that back.
Yep. Rey's lightsaber. This has shown up in various, you know, social media outlets before. But I did run into the Rey electronic lightsaber at Target earlier this week. Well, I guess yesterday even. This is one that's part of the Blade Builders line.
So okay.
It does have the batteries, and so it makes the sound and everything. It's just compatible with that whole build a blade line.
I mean, technically, it's not really Rey's lightsaber, is it?
Right, really? And it doesn't even really say that. It just says Rey Starkiller Base. It doesn't say Rey's lightsaber, which is fine by me. I mean, either way, it's just a nice way to get more product out for Rey, I guess.
Well, it's an awesome one for Hasbro, isn't it? Really just a case of, hey, we can just, you know, slap a brand new label on this thing, because I'm assuming this has been out before. It looks
Well, identical. I'm not sure if... Has there been? I don't think there has been a Luke one that came out in the Blade Builders line.
Oh, in the I'm just getting confused between these two. Yeah,
because I thought about that too. I was like, oh, this is just a repack of whatever, but it's got the hole in the bottom that's compatible with the
extensions and stuff, which are good fun. They definitely are good fun.
So that I didn't buy it. I left it for some other collector.
Other reason.
Yeah, someone that might appreciate it more than I, even though I would love to have it, I just didn't figure I needed it at this time. So, and I went back to that same Target this morning and it was gone. So, it's all true. There was only one. So, what else is in here? Walgreens, excuse me, they're starting to get shipments of that Wrath, the Emperor's Wrath Darth Vader again. That exclusive 6-inch figure.
That's right. This you and I both bought it on drugstore.com thanks to Stud Shooter, and and then it disappeared.
Yep.
Literally. People were going crazy trying to find this thing, but it seems to be making a comeback, and you and I both kind of rated it quite highly, actually. So I think
it's a great figure.
It is a great figure. So yeah, definitely one to get. Yeah, just shows you. I mean, this might not have came back into stock, and there's a lot of people in the Black Series 6-inch forum. There's one on Facebook. There's plenty around the place, but people were really, wasn't Shock Troopers, it wasn't Phasmas, it was this. Mm-hmm. People could not find this figure, so it's one that's still in demand. But Walgreens, keep your check. Walgreens, the chance to get it. I've still not seen it at Walgreens online, so hopefully that'll come back.
Yep.
But yeah, good figure.
Speaking of 6-inch figures, pre-orders are, I think we mentioned this last month, but pre-orders are open for that latest wave of the 6-inch Black Series line. The assortment that includes the Kanan, Ahsoka, the Farm Boy Luke from A New Hope, and a repack of the Han.
That's right.
And also the troopers. And the, yeah, Snow Troopers. Mm. But I think what's interesting about this is that some of these figures, at least the images, look to be new. I don't recall seeing these poses and particular shots before. So get a few different new looks for Kanan, Luke, and Ahsoka.
Yep. These are just super, super popular. It's incredible how busy this wave is going to be. And Han is a repack again as well from that wave 5.
Yeah.
So you're probably going to find Snowtroopers abound, which is quite interesting, actually, because he's such a normally a really popular character. They seem to be doing very well with the... what do we call it? The repacks with some of the figures this year or the last few months anyway. They've chosen some good figures to repack. Phasma's came back or coming back. Snowtroopers again. All the kind of figures you would expect. So I'm assuming we'll get another crack at Ahsoka and hopefully Kanan down the line as well. So
yeah, I would hope.
Fingers crossed.
Oh, what else do we have here this week? I think that's kind of it for the Hasbro news for the most part. Mm-hmm. Moving on to Sideshow, Hot Toys and Sideshow had posted some new images for the upcoming Rey 6th scale figure. They have now included a different treatment for the head wrap and goggles that you can interchange, and as well they are packing the lightsaber in with her. So
it's very cool indeed. Or you could get the BB-8 pack in as well, can't you? That's yep. The alternate one there.
Yep. So these new accessories are included with both the standalone Rey figure or the BB-8 and Rey set.
And this is still a prototype, but even as a prototype, the facial sculpt looks
really nice.
It does. As good as you're going to get, I think, for Hot Toys. But then you never know. Sometimes they've done that, they've come back, and they just improve on it, just mm-hmm. which is rare like them. But it's a good-looking figure. She really looks great in that the head wrap. That's, yeah, blinking. You could almost think that's a shot from the movie.
But yep. I'm very tempted.
Go there. Go there. They're awesome.
It's just very cool. Great photography for those figures. It really shows off the likeness and mm-hmm. the accessories and even the different textures of the soft goods that are packed. I mean, that looks like real leather. That looks like real mm-hmm. you know, muslin or whatever they're mm-hmm. using for the fabric, but it's very cool.
They pay a lot of attention to it. God, it's beautiful. Yeah, very cool figure indeed. Very tempted.
Let's see what else. Sideshow also officially recognized and put details up for the Shock Trooper. The Hot Toys Shock Trooper is now the first of a series of video game based 6th scale figures, which I thought was kind of interesting.
It is, yeah. Lots more to come. So I'd be surprised about that, actually, doing a Resistance Trooper if they do go that way.
Mm-hmm.
They generally don't sell as well as the troopers do, but that's a nice easy one again for them to do. Just take a stormtrooper and get some paint done and a little tweak on the backpack, which seems to be modified.
Right.
I don't really see paint being the difference on the backpack to my eye, but it's yeah, for me, and I'm being really anal because I'm anal about Hot Toys, but the jaw seems to be very long down to the helmet. That's my one little weird
right.
Picky thing. I don't know. Something about it doesn't sit quite right with me, but it's probably just a repaint of the existing Stormtrooper. So I've maybe not mm-hmm. looked at it up close enough, but plenty of weapons, backpack, weathering. What's not yep. to love, really? Looks great.
Pretty nice. Mm. Tempting as well.
I know. Everything's tempting when it comes to Hot Toys.
Can only collect so much, and we're going to get into that here in a bit with some of the Funko news that has come out the past week or so. Just crazy. It seems like as soon as they announce them, they're gone, or as soon as they announce them, they show up at retail, and they're subsequently gone. You had posted a link here to Dorkside Toys.
Yeah, they just, again, a lot of retailers, I'm just going to show that now, there we go. A lot of retailers had posted this set out there, but it's selling really, really fast. A lot of places have sold out, so Dorkside Toys still has some stock left. But I love this Sido Nathano guy. He's just beautifully done, and I've seen one or two of these out the box. I think you've got one as well.
Yep.
The weathering on that helmet of his is beautiful, and a little knife or blaster by his side, and it's a really well-painted and well-made figure. I, from my experience in buying Funko and selling Funko, this is one of those figures that will, in about 6 months to 8 months time, people will already be paying 18, 20, 25 bucks for, because he will, people will ignore him and they won't buy him. And he's just a great looking little figure, I think. But so is Akbar. So is Leia. She looks good too. Baboon's ass haircut. She, to quote Carrie Fisher, Akbar looks great. Good old Carrie Fisher. Do we ever have an Akbar before? I don't think we did.
His traditional, well, his Return of the Jedi
outfit. His white smock is like, I could not remember if that had been out before. Nainum with his known, well, really he has his pilot's kind of
cap
thing on. So it's kind of pre-helmet Nainum, I guess.
Yep.
The haircut. And a couple of people have commented Princess Leia there, but Funko had confirmed, I don't know if you saw it, they confirmed that Lucasfilm had asked them to put Princess Leia on the packaging because obviously this is printed three, four months mm-hmm. well in advance, and they wanted to keep it a secret as to her rank. So there you go.
I find that funny because they've produced General Leia merchandise before.
In Funko?
No, Hasbro.
That's true.
Back when there was those little... I think it was during the Power of the Jedi line, there was like those little force files that came. They're like little pamphlet type things. I don't mm-hmm. know if you remember those.
I do. Yeah.
Right at the bottom, you know, general as her rank, you know, that was clear back during Return of the Jedi. So I'm not sure why her being a general seems to be such a revelation now. I guess.
I mean, it could be fun. Yeah.
Anyway,
it could be Funko made a mistake and they were just covering up and saying that, but it kind of makes sense.
Yeah. But. What else? More pop stuff. You had mentioned that figures like the Rey and the BB-8 are really in demand now.
They are. They're selling incredibly quickly, and it's the ones that, this is your collection we're sharing right now.
I know.
Which should be mentioned. You're really growing fast in this collection. You're going, man. You're. This was like a few shows ago when you had nothing, and you've got them all. Literally, I think. Red Arm 3PO.
Yep, he's in there. I got two of those. One's the exclusive, and one's the regular release. I don't have all of the new Force Awakens ones yet. I'm still missing Akbar, the regular Nine Nub. I have the pilot one. You can see there on the top. Mm-hmm. I still need the Varmic, which is essentially the Hask Thug character. And then there's a couple other exclusives that have yet to be officially released. They've been announced and shown off. We'll get to one here in a second that I can't wait for. it's just hilarious, I think. These Funko things, I'm going to be in trouble. I'm just sticking with The Force Awakens so far, but...
I love this. We have a record of you here on video.
Yeah, I'm already going to blow. I'm totally going to discount it because the next box that Funko has for their Smuggler's Bounty, the theme is the Cantina from A New Hope. So it's not like I don't have other non-Force Awakens ones, but now it's just going to drag me in. I'm going to have to go back and backfill certain figures or I don't know. They're just great. I mean, for $10, they're cute little things. They look great in the box. You're not, you know, it's nice window packaging.
They're plentiful in most cases.
Yep. Easy to find, relatively. Seems like every major retailer carries the line, for one thing, and mm-hmm. also has their own exclusive, which makes it fun and unique and collectible. So I like that about them. It kind of, I think I've mentioned this before, it kind of took the place of the Kubrick fascination that a lot of us had a long time ago. Those were fun to chase down every year they came out with a series. But yeah, these are a lot more inexpensive and a lot easier to find than some of those harder collectibles.
Yep, I agree. They're good fun. And again, you can dive in. And episode 7 is a fantastic... starting point, I think, as you've done, just to kind of dive in and start collecting them, because again, you know, some you don't have to collect them all. You physically can't. There's so many, But it's a great time to start collecting them. And Funko just seem to be, again, the sculpts and the molds, I think, particularly for me, Sidon, Varmic, or Varnik, whatever he's called, is really nice designs, really, really cool designs, unique. You know, they're not generally that same standard black eyes pulp that you've seen before. So, yeah, they're nice. Very cool indeed.
I was going to mention something about that, and I lost it. But, yeah, it's just one of those things that, you know, Funko really has it together as far as character selection and and stuff like that. It's not a lot of, I mean, they do reissues, as people are probably aware, that follow the line, but they change it up. They offer variants and different things like that. So yeah, it's just a fun thing.
Good fun line.
If you're into that, speaking of variants anyway, Funko did a Periscope video, like an unboxing the other day, regarding the Force Awakens new assortment. And they revealed that there's going to be a Kylo Ren unmasked version that's going to be exclusive to Walmart here soon.
Which will translate to pop culture for the rest of the world or Forbidden Planet in the UK. But yeah, Kylo Ren unmasked. This was way expected. We knew this was coming.
Yeah.
This is the third Kylo now in, what, 3 months?
Really? Yeah. Well, since September.
Since September, sorry, you're right, September, my apologies. So masked, unmasked, BG here, and we're going to get one in a swimsuit shortly. We'll get... No,
okay. Scarred one, maybe?
Scarred one? Yeah, do you know, that will absolutely be an exclusive. You're absolutely
Luke Crate exclusive, or Luke Crate.
Yeah, with a little bit of blood on his side or hitting his... He'll be fisting his stomach to kind of get more blood. Yep, that'll be another one. So, yeah, very cool.
Yep, can't wait. People are, I mean, they're super, I don't know, like I said, they're fun, they're popular, they're cute. It's just a fun line to get into.
It's the new cocaine. It's Funko
Pop. It is. It's like cardboard. I was going to say cardboard crack, but those are pull tabs for people, for gamblers out there. Let's see what else. There is a custom one that had shown up online from that same person on Twitter, Across the Stars. There was a custom Snoke Pop, which is kind of cool. Actually, it's kind of an Emperor-esque version.
It is, isn't it?
But bigger than the standard Pops.
Yeah, well, I mean, again, Funko knows no bounds, really. I mean, you could get a larger 6-inch scale Snoke. I don't know quite how wonderfully appealing that would be, but because he would be all blue, I guess, with his
get a translucent variant for hologram.
Dude, you know them. You know if they can get an avenue to give you something, they will give you it. So
they could give me a call, and I'll help with product development and suggestions.
And get some ideas. But it's a nice custom. There's a ton of customs. We'll talk more about that later on. But yeah, there's plenty of cool customs out there for Pop. Plenty of them, indeed.
I want to get an extra Stormtrooper, First Order Stormtrooper, so I could repaint it as Finn, you know, 2187, where he has the three... The bloody stripes. Well,
I thought that'd been announced already.
I don't think so. Do they? Is it?
I'm sure I saw that in Reddit. I am sure I saw that in Reddit.
Send me a link. I need to see it.
It'll be coming. It'll be coming. I guarantee you.
What else? Smuggler's Bounty Box. That just wrapped up the other day on the 15th of January for the Resistance Box. And it's already started showing up for subscribers. So I received my box today. We won't spoil.
Do we see spoiler alert and share more, or?
I'm willing. Are you willing? Do you care?
I'm willing. I think, you know, look, if you know, don't watch. if you don't want to know, don't watch.
For 3 or 4 minutes, don't watch. We're going to open this box live. Here's the box. I don't know if I'm...
So go run, make a coffee, cup of tea, go to the toilet, go away. Yep.
Here's the box here. BB-8, Force Awakens box.
Live unboxing, people.
Live unboxing. You get another patch. This time it is BB-8.
Very cute. Beauty.
Yep, Resistance. You get another pin or badge, depending on where you're from. Pin that has Poe Dameron.
And have you seen any variants in those patches or pins? It's not in that, is
no.
it? It's just the, no, yeah.
I have not. there's a new shirt that's included. I don't know if there are variants in the shirt. Like last time there were four, but there's a cool...
That's the only one I've seen, yep.
Yep, it's got pop versions of the characters of Finn, Poe, Han, Chewie, Rey, the Falcon. Who else is on here? BB-8, X-Wing, pretty neat. Let's get to the pop. The pop is, as we speculated and as Funko actually teased, it is a flocked version of Chewbacca.
So very cool indeed.
Can't really see.
So what's the little sticker there? Is it for the box Nazis out there? Smugglers made it exclusive. Yep. Nice.
The other boxes were printed with Smuggler's Bounty at the top right here. It was physically printed on here instead of having a sticker.
That's right.
I think the only reason they did that was because this is number 63, which was the same box as the regular Chewbacca that came out.
Makes sense. Save money. So use the box.
Reuse the box, yeah. Because it still has the same original characters on the back from the initial launch. But yeah, he's a fuzzy little flocked Chewie.
So. Nice. I love that mold of that character. Now, inside that, I've noticed on some of the brand new pops, there's a Smuggler's Bounty postcard inside.
Yep.
And this one in the back of the box. Yep. Ah, okay. So that seems to be the norm for some of the pops anyway. So there's a little advertisement for Smuggler's Bounty in the back of the box.
Yep.
And it's always been a common thing for a lot of Star Wars pops to have a kind of, not a star field as such, but a color card in the back, which does not seem to appear in any other pop of any kind.
Yeah, because like with the, I'm just going to open this one quick. The box or the insert for all of the Force Awakens one have the
First Order, the logo. Yep. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Very cool. There's also one other item that is packed in the box. Instead of having two pops and a possible variant for the other one that's included, they only included the one Funko Pop, but they also included a new item, which is part of the Pop Home collection. And it's a C-3PO ceramic mug from The Force Awakens. And I'll pull this out quick. Kind of interesting that they... Because I've seen some of the Marvel ones. I don't know if you've seen those before.
I have, yes. The Cap and Iron Man and a few of them before. Yep.
But there's a C-3PO mug. And he's got a little red handle. So
nice touch.
Yeah, nice...
It looks pretty big. It looks pretty deep.
Drink your tea and hot soup or whatever you want. Your hot glog, whatever you want.
Blue milk.
Yep. So that was it for the Smuggler's Box. So
nice. It's surprising to see that, Marvel makes more sense. They've stuck to comics. And at the same time, DC or Funko have launched their DC offering this week as well. So
yeah.
Three boxes on the go to purchase if you're a comic book and Star Wars fan. So, choose your boxes. Plus look great, plus whatever else. So, created marketplace. Very creative, but good fun.
Let's see. And speaking of more and more pops, you had started a new podcast show.
I did. A pop podcast or pop recap. We came up with that the last. I stole it from our show here, but we had tried all popcast, pop this, pop that. I couldn't quite come up with the name, but a friend of mine here in the US, Art Kim, he's a real toy fanatic, all sorts of stuff. But we both love pop. Got talking and said, "Look, let's just try this and have a little show." So had a blast, loved it. So we talked for an hour and a half of all sorts of stuff on pop, from the beginning of pop when it actually came in a clamshell. Some people don't know that, to some of the rarities out there, the values of some stuff. And we're going to go to some of the cost of some of the harder to find pop in some of the future episodes. Thousands of dollars for some pop. It's insane. So, check it out. And we'll be doing some more because it was great fun.
Very cool. I look forward to listening.
Thank you.
Let's see. Some custom news here. Quick little touches we'll discuss. A Jango Fett repaint. This was something that had shown up, I think, on Instagram over the weekend. Mm. Basically, it was taken the Black Series Jango Fett figure and repainted it not a retool, not a resculpt, but just a very intricate repaint, and it looks it looks hot toy quality.
It really does. I think it shows you the core, the plastic is a very shiny, there is no weathering, there is no, it's just eyebrows, eyes, that's it. And just what a difference that kind of matte paint can make there. The shading, there's a beard stubble coming through, there's kind of darker rings around the eyes, and wow.
Yep, wow. It's a fantastic job, fantastic quality, perfect representation of Tamara Morrison.
Exactly. So it just shows you what Hasbro set out to do, and how just, you know, paint and cost and time is what it ends up to be. Not a bad figure by any means, the one on the left, the Hasbro version, but you and I shared and talked about this before, and I don't think it was the same person, but it was the Poe Dameron figure, the kind of go home, you're drunk Poe X-Wing, and what a difference just a little bit of paint could make. It wasn't a new sculpt, just a little bit of paint, so... Yeah, I wish I had the time and talent to do this, Frank.
I know.
But good-looking figure.
Very nice. Let's see. Before the show, you and I had talked about this Iron Studios item. We could, why don't we save that one to the last bit on the on the list. But we'll go to the Kylo lightsaber custom that I had saw online. There was a YouTube video. I can't remember who it's from. Obviously,
Cosplay Chris from Down Under.
It's taking the Hasbro lightsaber, the part of the build or the Blade Builders line, and just by simply repainting it, weathering it with some very simple techniques using shoe polish, you know, primer, some different color paints, it makes this thing look movie prop accurate.
He does a stupendous video. It's 13 minutes long and just loads, really clear, really professional, really well done video, which really helps, I think, as well.
Yeah.
And he shows you, it's a slick, slick video. He's 14,000 odd subscribers there, so definitely check out his channel. But really high quality, shows you really how to do this. And again, it's a low cost toy. And the final item, we'll try and show you the comparison here just towards the end, but amazing effect he gets in the little intricate pieces just by adding paint in the right places. Let me just see, there's a shot here, there we go, side by side comparison. That's the before shot, the Hasbro one, the follow-up one there that he makes, that's what he gets.
It's
awesome.
It
looks stunning.
So good.
And that next to the Black Series Kylo Ren's large full-scale helmet would just look, if you're a Kylo fan and you want to go around smashing things up, then you need this.
Ever it's a good since find. Thanks. Ever since I watched this video, I've been trying to find this lightsaber because I'm going to do it. I've made lightsabers before. I've done customs and whatnot. So I think I could handle doing that. So I'd really like to try it.
You know that probably companies like Anovos will probably make something, or EFX Collectibles will make something like this. And I mean, they make great quality stuff at great prices, but I mean, this is still cheap. If you have time, awesome. It's good.
For a $10 lightsaber and, you know, maybe $10 in paint and shoe polish, you might be able to come up with a
shoe polish.
That's, with a pretty believable representation of the lightsaber. So, looking forward to it. What else? There was another custom here. We'll talk about this a little bit. Adam Driver hosted Saturday Night Live this past weekend, and they had done a skit called Undercover Boss, which is based on the television show where he goes undercover. Kylo Ren goes undercover as Matt, the radar technician, and, you know, kind of under the radars, interviews his employees. You know, they're on Starkiller Base, and it's just hilarious. He plays it so well, this dry humor, and him playing himself as Kylo Ren is pretty hilarious. But this, someone had done a custom, Corey from First Order Transmission shared this image with me, and I posted it online as well. Just very funny. Matt, the radar technician, custom figure.
Exactly. He's had some great fun at Saturday Night Live, just not being what we thought Adam Driver was and really getting into having some fun. So, yeah, Saturday Night Live is definitely a very US thing because I didn't quite – I've seen Undercover Boss, but I must admit there were some funny moments there. But
yeah.
It's,
I haven't had my muffin, Matt.
Yeah, no, that's true. Need to get your muffin.
That's pretty good. This is what I was just referencing here. I noticed this on Facebook. This was shared on through a Mexico Facebook page. There's this company, Iron Studio, which I had never heard of before. They are doing 1/10 scale statues. And they have this new one posted online of Emperor Palpatine, and it's really good.
Good, good.
Good.
Wow, that's he's one fugly dude.
Yeah, that's a great sculpt.
And of course, this is material. I'm gathering.
I don't know.
Oh, that's got to be material, man. That's way too good. Wow. To get plastic to sit like that, I guess it's molded or sculpted, but and lights on it too, I believe. Wow, you're right. It could well be plastic. I thought that was material. Got the ugly teeth going as well.
It's a great likeness again with this company.
I guess Palps wasn't too bothered about not getting the ladies, really.
It's, no.
Or getting any sun, for that matter. But wow.
It's pretty
1/10.
Yeah.
So that.
What is that? Okay. Yeah, 1/10.
1/10. So under.
Like 7-inch scale.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Very detailed.
They do make. There are some other items they offer in their line. There's a Yoda, which I had not seen before, and I might have to find. I'm not sure. There's a Princess Leia from A New Hope. There is. Who else was in there? There's another one I can't recall offhand. Some sort of a Darth Vader helmet. I'm not sure if it was a teaser for a full Darth Vader piece that they're going to do, but they had shown something. So if you take the link we'll have in the show notes or go to the yakface.com Facebook page, you could get the URL for the actual website and you could check out the page. So pretty cool.
Hmm.
Good
to see new Star Wars stuff.
What else? Moving on to TV, movie, book, and game news. We had just talked about this, the Undercover Boss with Starkiller Base. This is, you could watch it on YouTube. Again, we'll have a link in the show notes. Yeah. But,
it's just taking a little minute to load here.
Yeah.
A video amongst here somewhere.
There'll be cosplayers of Matt.
Yeah, there will be one there. They'll just...
Any future convention will have this, I'm sure.
There we go. Yes. Radar technician. I like it.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Matt. He's just, it's so funny. If it's people
glasses
haven't seen it,
as well.
You have to watch it. It's just, it's very funny.
Cool.
What else? This was something that had shown up on Twitter. I had seen this as well. Apparently, Han Solo shops at Target. He looks like he's wearing his Han Solo jacket.
It does, doesn't it? Oh, man. Yeah, he's punching his pin, saying in his name.
Punch. So,
yeah, punch a Chewie. Oh, that's funny. That is funny. So what? The person who took this must have been pretty damn close.
Yeah,
or how does
maybe that explains camera, so. Maybe that explains Harrison's look on his face.
I know. The
disgusted, like,
get me out of here!
Yeah, how dare you, sir? What else? Comics. A new comic series was announced from USA Today on what day was that? I guess that was Thursday or Friday last week. Poe Dameron. Comic series.
Love the cover. Very Top Gun esque with that logo there, but almost kind of propaganda like poster. Beautiful art. as well. Still loving the Star Wars Marvel. I think we're up to issue 14 or something now, but the story is kind of getting a bit wobbly as far as I'm concerned. But it's, no, I'm sure it's not really canon, really, hopefully. Yeah, this could be a cool little side story for Poe.
Maybe we'll
see who he came into acquisition of BB-8 or something. I don't know. Could be interesting.
Yeah, different missions. It kind of goes into the USA Today article about what the general theme is going to be about. It's not a mini series either. It's supposed to be an ongoing title. So we'll see how long that lasts. You know, like the Chewbacca one was only, I think, a six or seven issue. Run. This one is supposed to be an ongoing series, so we'll see how long that lasts. What else? Soundtrack.
Yes, this is unusual.
The John Williams fan website, jwfan.com, had posted an article about a version that gets sent out for consideration for the Academy Awards, and there are tracks on this disc that aren't on the regular retail release. So there are a few, I think, I can't remember what they said, three or four missing, or not missing, but unreleased tracks on here. And in this article, again, we'll share in the show notes, you can listen to them, and technically you could download them for free off of the site. So
yeah, that was unusual. I'm surprised this hasn't had a cease and desist as yet, because it effectively is the same as the retail soundtrack, albeit a very low bitrate of 160 kilobit. That's perfectly listenable, though, for most people.
And those links are hosted by Walt Disney Sounds. So, I mean,
Walt Disney condones, or not condones, they actually promote piracy. There you go, people. They've split some of the way they've got the Attack in the Jakku Village Part 1 and Part 2. It's just, I believe, one track on the regular soundtrack. Things like that are a little different.
Right.
But, if you want to have both, such as me, then that was a great way to get it. And it's free. So, there you go.
It'd be interesting to try to get one of those for your consideration copies, the actual physical copies, because those are, you know, soundtrack type things and music and whatnot are always very collectible with certain groups. So not too many of those would exist, I would think.
No, I think that would be a pretty rare item. And I'm sure somewhere even around that disc or some mention of it is, you know, this is for private use or something only, but for some reason it's up on Walt Disney Studios.
Right.
So go get it.
Very nice.
What more do you need?
Yep. And starting tomorrow, we get the return of Star Wars Rebels, and was a new 3-minute long trailer that was released by Disney and Lucasfilm as an overview of what's to come in this second season. We're in the second half of the season, and it looks to be super intense.
It really does. And a lot of connections to The Force Awakens. Here we get Cham Syndulla returning, and I think that's really, was it?
Numa.
Numa, or I can't remember. Numa, thank you.
Yeah.
She's all grown up.
From the Clone Wars.
From the Clone Wars, yeah. That'll be interesting. Princess Leia's back there. Inquisitors are back there. We get to see... Now, this was kind of interesting. It's basically Ralph McQuarrie giant spiders from Dagobah concepts, which they've incorporated. So, geez, I mean, they throw nothing away from Ralph and Joe Johnson early sketches out there. It's, I think Ralph's doodles will eventually somehow get into a movie or a TV show somehow.
Even Princess Leia's outfit is based on
original
sketches for Princess Leia, and that's before Carrie Fisher was even cast as Leia.
Yeah, some very unusual sets and pieces and storylines, and someone who, if you watch the trailer, calls himself Master, which I think causing a little bit of a controversy as to who this quite might be.
interesting.
Your guess is, it is very interesting. Watch the trailer. I think that's probably the best piece of advice.
Yep.
But I think the highlight, or the not the highlight, but the thing that caught everyone's attention was the fact that we get to see a Kylo, well, Jedi Temple Guard for a start. This almost looked a little dream sequence-y to me.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of that going to be going on in the Star Wars universe.
Mm-hmm. And I don't have it here, but there was a little snippet we get to see of a triple-bladed lightsaber very similar to Kylo Ren's. It's in here somewhere, the little screenshot. But anyway, watch the trailer. You'll see it. But that was kind of interesting, bit of Anakin as well. It's a juicy, packed trailer. There's a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah, it's for 3 minutes. It's pretty in depth as far as what we're gonna see and experience. I'm really looking forward to this second half of the season. You get to see Vader and Ahsoka confront each other. It looks like it's gonna be great, I think.
Exactly. So kudos to the marketing department at the Star Wars for the Force Awakens, and then we get Rebels and some other stuff and leading up to Rogue One, hopefully. So.
Yeah, because I have
interesting stuff.
I was kind of afraid that Rebels would kind of disappear into the background once The Force Awakens came out and was released, and people were really focused on that. But I think people are anxious to get back into Rebels.
More Star Wars. The thirst for it is huge. I mean, I noticed a lot of the Force Awakens pops and merchandise was actually kind of sitting on pegs and not going anywhere. Mm-hmm. The minute that movie came out.
Yep.
Try and find a Rey or a BB-8. It's a little hard to find these things now. So the movie's made its mark.
Very much so. Let's see what else. That brings us to our reviews and new purchases and acquisitions for the week since our last show. How about you for reviews?
No reviews this week, just that little pop podcast that we did. But you had a few things on the go.
Oh, yep. I posted just yesterday, I posted the Ronin Boba Fett from Band Nations, which is a fantastic, it's one of my favorite collectibles. Again, just like the Vader was when I had posted that, the Boba Fett in this line is fantastic in every way.
Mm. It's a beautiful figure without a doubt. I love the kind of almost Jango-esque suit underneath the purple color. It's a nice little nod in some ways, but mine's still in the box. I haven't even opened the damn thing yet. So I've had it for months and it's been sitting there. I bought mine from overseas, but and the Stormtrooper too, but they're great figures. I opened them, had a quick look at them, but that's, it's beautiful. Love the weathering and all the little details on the shoulders, and it's a cool, cool figure.
Yep, a lot of accessories. There are a bunch of, throwing weapons that attach to his boots, and one that hooks onto his wrist, and he's got his katana, and he's got a very Boba Fett-esque rifle that comes with it. Done in the Japanese style, or it kind of looks like a musket or a flintlock rifle, but it's fantastic. I can't say enough good things about it.
That's badass. Like
the actual little hammer on the blaster moves, so you could cock it back. It doesn't, release or anything like that, but it's
just moves.
Yep, he's got a posable rangefinder. All these old knives. Yep, they all come off. Lots of accessories. Jetpack comes off. Rocket comes off the jetpack.
It's a smooth, smooth figure.
Yep.
Yeah. This was quite a hard one. I mean, I originally, Dorset Toys didn't have up originally a wee back. When I was getting it, I tried to place an order on Amazon and they canceled my order because they weren't going to get enough stuff. It was actually allocated. And then just in case we didn't get any, I bought one overseas. And then lo and behold, we could get them. Right. So we managed to get tons of them. So if you're still looking for this thing, it's up at Dorkside. But it's a beautiful piece. It really, the colors just pop in your photographs.
It photographed really well. It's almost like a jade color, very Japan-inspired color, I would think, and it goes well with his actual color scheme anyway. But yeah, it's great. I just love every bit of it.
You had fun shooting this, you can tell. There's just lots of cool details. A little almost like rust on the helmet there as well.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of yellowy details. Yep, he's a beauty. Very cool. And there's lots more to come as well. We've got quite a bunch to come. Another Darth with not this one here. This is the very first one here with the Imperial emblem. We've got the gigantic sun one to come, I think.
The Death Star crest.
Death Star one, yeah. No,
Death Star armor is the second version that comes out. That one's a little bit different. He's got different details. He comes with two swords. Again, some armor differences and color differences, but I totally am in on that one as well. I have the first Stormtrooper that is coming. I have that one. I have to do some photography for that here soon. There's a Sand Trooper version. There's going to be the Royal Guard version. There's another Stormtrooper that comes with some drums.
That's right. Is that another Sand Trooper?
Yeah, there's a Sand Trooper and there's another Stormtrooper. I can't remember. Oh, that's right. There's a list there in the on that toy guide page.
Royal Guard.
Upcoming ones.
Yep.
So.
Ah, okay. Awesome.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, I started off with one, the Stormtrooper, and then it was Boba, and it's another line. Yes, you've. My apologies. You've got a note exactly there of all the ones that are coming. So Samurai, Tishu, Darth Vader, Ashigaru, Stormtrooper, Darth Vader, Death Star Armor, yep. Sand Trooper, Imperial Guard, Jango Fett, that's right. That's right, which is a repaint of this. Nice.
Can't wait.
Well, it's another line we're going to be buying. Good.
Yeah. And I think as I've mentioned before, when we've talked about this line, these aren't the most inexpensive pieces that have come around. I mean, they're essentially four times the price of the Black Series 6-inch figure. But you pay, what you get is what you pay for. I mean, the detail is there, the articulation is there. Yeah. They're just a fantastic piece. Museum quality, I would say.
Yes, they are. I mean, even I'm just looking at the Stormtrooper here again, and we showed the Darth. You did some great photography on the Darth before, which really, really nearly put me over the edge buying it. It's incredibly well detailed. The bone and the armor, they're really good. They're really good. So highly recommended.
What else did I have in here? I did receive my 6-scale C-3PO from Sideshow this week. I'm working on some photography for that. I posted a little teaser image last night on Twitter, I think, Twitter. It's a very cool piece. I have it right here. Let me click this back up. Here's the C-3PO. You just touch the back of his head, and it's got a little activation. Nice. You know, his regular rusty port in the back of his head. It's not really a switch per se. It's just finger touch sensitive.
Same as the R2.
Which I really like. Lots of cool details and weathering.
That looks really good.
Yeah. It's got a silver leg. It's not reflective, but it is. It's shiny. It's got a nice patina to the finish. What's really kind of the selling point, I would say, here is the fingers. Each finger is fully articulated, each knuckle.
Nice.
So you can get some cool, I guess, hand gestures out of it if you want. it's a great, pretty great piece. I would say there's a few things I would knock about it, but nothing that would prevent me from buying it per se, since I have it. It's really nice, nicely done. Articulation is good for what it is. I mean, he's not the most mobile of characters in the Star Wars universe.
Exactly. But,
it's
he looks great, even with the lights off. The detail in his eyes, and it's prevalent on the photograph. I'll just share again for people seeing that Jason shared out on his Twitter account. Yeah. Those fine little lines on his eyes are. I mean, that's. That's intricate stuff, man. That's really hard to do. Very cool.
He also has, let me tilt my screen back here quick. He also has a switch out part for his arm where you could pull it off, and he's got his little, after he gets attacked by the Tusken Raider.
Tusken Raider? So, or a Wookiee, maybe? An expanded universe? Ripped his arm off?
Yep.
For cheating at Holo Chess?
Right.
Cool.
So there was that, and then...
Anything else?
There was a Kylo Ren, the Disney Infinities line. I talked about it, I think, a couple shows ago. I posted a quick little toy guide gallery for that item online.
It's a great pose. It's a really good pose that Disney have kind of captured there of him.
Yep.
Very nice indeed. And there is a laid up version of this coming, I think we talked about.
Yeah, I would think so.
Yeah, there's a couple of good offers. I think this Saturday, Toys R Us is having a buy two for 17, I think it is.
Yeah, that's good.
So it's about $8 each. So if you want to get this one, still no Boba Fett. I wait patiently.
Yeah, it's been released in Australia, I saw.
In Australia, yes, that's right. Thanks to Michael Crowell for sharing. What's up, Chief? So yeah, very good.
Very nice. New toy purchases and acquisitions for the week. How about you? Good stuff.
Nothing really Star Wars. I guess we'd include, because I've not really spoken about the Boba Fett, Samurai Boba Fett. I've had it for a while, but I've not really talked about it. What did I buy? A lot of pop, actually, this week. A lot of known Star Wars pop, a lot of Batman 1966 stuff. Uh-huh. As soon as I saw that Lego set this week, if you've not seen it, the Lego Batcave was announced this week. And just sent me all Batman 1966 crazy, and I had to get the pops. So for them, and Marvel Legends Absorbing Wave from Darkseid, some great figures in that wave. The Spider-Gwen and the Venom, if you're a Marvel fan. Really popular. Selling out like crazy. And some Iron Man Lego. So Iron Man and Batman Lego from the new sets, the Batman versus Superman and the Red Skull sub-attack Iron Man. So no Star Wars for me this week at all.
Let's see. What did I have? A few things.
looking at your list. I'm like, whoa!
Mostly pop-related. I talked about those before. I picked up the Princess Leia, the Han Solo, the Sidon Ithano, Pilot, Nine Nub, that's exclusive from GameStop. The Smuggler's Bounty Box that came. The Ashigaru Stormtrooper came. I did order that second version of the Darth Vader samurai figure. So I have that Death Star version coming. I received the Amazon exclusive.
Oh, cool. The 3.75 stuff.
Yeah. That's this box here. The box is smaller than I thought. I don't know why I thought it was going to be larger than this, but it's...
Oh, it is small, yeah. It's kind of like a GameCube.
Yeah. It's got a cool... The packaging design is really pretty brilliant. It's got like a Velcro strap on the side, then it just folds out and you get these different figures. Repack of Phasma, TIE Pilot, Flame Trooper, and you get the Riot Control Trooper, which is the first offering in this set. You get the Heavy Artillery Trooper, which is the first offering for this line, and then a repack of the regular Snow Trooper and a regular First Order Storm Trooper. So it's very cool.
Yeah, it's very nice.
Good army builder set for about, it's less than $50. So it's pretty good for all those figures, I would say.
Yeah, Amazon always do price their exclusives very fairly and competitively, that's for sure. So,
yep. And then finally this week, picked up from Costco on sale, the Art of the Force Awakens book.
Nice.
Had to get that. It's
Had a chance to look through it much yet? Or
I haven't gone really deep down in depth in it yet. Haven't read a lot of it. I've just kind of browsed through some of the pictures, but man, there's a lot of cool unused stuff in there. So
it really was.
Be interesting to see how much of it pops up in some sort of media, whether it's the next film, you know, the episode 8, or, you know, concepts get reused for Rebels, and we'll see. But a ton of gorgeous, gorgeous art from a lot of talented artists.
Definitely. The I thought the in the book itself, there's a lot of concepts around what look would end up being designed or to look like. Really bizarre suggestions, as they said within the book. It's almost that they were encouraged to just go all out and just kind of crazy ideas, and they did some great ones and some very bizarre ones. So, which makes it really interesting read, I think, or there's not much to read in it, but to look at it. So, yeah, it's a good book.
Very good.
Good book.
I think with that, that wraps up this week's show. As always, like thank everyone for watching and sharing and commenting. We will be back. Well, what's this week? This next week? Are you available next week?
I am indeed. I am indeed.
Sounds like we have a show planned. Again, closer to Toy Fair we get, the more stuff will start to leak out. I would imagine a few more will be available to talk about for next week's show. So until next time, again, thanks everyone for watching, and we'll see you next time.
See you later.